Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP ENCOR, Enterprise Core exam. This course will cover all topics you need to know to pass the ENCOR exam. In this video, we will look at SDM, Switching Database Manager. SDM is a tool in Cisco switches that allows you to configure how much of the switch's TCAM memory is allocated for each purpose, such as layer 2 forwarding, layer 3 forwarding, ACLs, QoS, etc. A switch's TCAM resources aren't unlimited, so depending on how you use the switch, you might have to use SDM to make sure the TCAM resources are allocated to suit your needs. Here's what we'll cover. First, I'll briefly introduce what SDM templates are, and then we'll get right into configuring and verifying SDM templates. This will be a fairly short video. SDM isn't such a deep topic, but it's an important feature that you might have to use in the field. So, what is SDM? First of all, it stands for Switching Database Manager or Management, and some Cisco documentation calls it Switch Device Manager. That's not the standard name. I don't know if whoever wrote that documentation was mistaken or if it's an official name. Either way, not a big deal. SDM allows you to allocate the switch's TCAM resources for different purposes. For example, a switch used purely for layer 2 switching might need more resources for MAC addresses. A switch used for both layer 2 and layer 3 will need a balance of MAC addresses and layer 3 routes. And a switch using ACLs, NAT, QoS, etc. will need TCAM resources for those purposes. The point is, switches don't have an unlimited amount of memory to store their forwarding tables. So, depending on how you use the switch, you should allocate that memory accordingly. Switches that support SDM will have a few pre-built SDM templates. Each of them allocate the TCAM resources differently. And note that some devices also allow you to make custom SDM templates, although we won't cover that in this video. The available templates depend on the switch model and software version. Here are a few examples. The Catalyst 9300 has Access and NAT templates. The Catalyst 9600 has Core, NAT, and Distribution templates. This is an older model, but the Catalyst 3750 had Access, Default, Routing, and VLAN templates. Each switch model has different templates with different names. You don't have to remember them. Just know that each of these templates allocates TCAM differently. Now, before moving on, I want to share an excerpt from some Cisco documentation about the 3750. It's a bit long, but explains the purpose of SDM well. Since the Catalyst 3750 can be used in numerous different applications, flexibility in TCAM subsystems resource allocation is vital. To this end, there are three predefined SDM templates that can be used to divide the TCAM to suit the use of the Catalyst 3750. The first one is the routing template, which maximizes the system resources for unicast routing. The routing template would typically be used when the box is used as a router or route aggregator in the center of the network. The VLAN template is the second one, and with this template, unicast routing is disabled, allowing the maximum number of supported MAC addresses. The VLAN template would be used when the switch is being used as a purely Layer 2 device. Finally, there is the default template, which is a mix between the routing and VLAN templates. This template gives a good balance between Layer 2 and Layer 3 capabilities. Notice that this excerpt doesn't mention the access template that I listed for the 3750 above. As I said, the available templates depends not just on the hardware model, but also the software version. So here's a chart showing the TCAM allocations for each of the 3750's SDM templates. For example, up top we have unicast MAC addresses. This is how many MAC addresses it can fit in its MAC address table. The VLAN SDM template allows 12,000 MAC addresses, whereas the routing template allows for only 3,000, with the other two options in between. Here are unicast routes. Of course, the routing template provides the most, with 11,000, whereas the VLAN template allows for zero routes. So the VLAN template should only be used if the switch will be used purely for layer 2 switching. No routing at all. And here are some others regarding policy-based routing, QoS, and security ACEs, access control entries. In this case, the access template allocates the most resources. So if the switch has to use a lot of ACLs, QoS, or policy-based routing, you might want to use this template. Note that we haven't covered policy-based routing in the course. Feel free to Google it if you're curious, but it's not an ENCOR exam topic. Now, if you're like me, you might have a question when looking at this chart. If CAM and TCAM are separate memory, how can SDM be used to move resources from MAC addresses, CAM, to routes, ACLs, QoS, etc., which are done with TCAM? Well, the answer is that in many modern devices, the CAM and TCAM are actually one shared memory pool that can be allocated as needed. Basically, it's all just TCAM, not CAM and TCAM. TCAM matches using masks, like subnet masks, to identify which bits it cares about. For example, when looking up a route in the routing table, it uses the prefix length to determine the most specific match. When using TCAM for layer 2 entries, the mask value is all Fs, that's 48 bits set to 1. All bits of the mask are 1 to look for an exact match, no partial matches. As you know, layer 3 forwarding looks for the most specific match, and partial matches are okay, as determined by the mask. However, layer 2 forwarding requires exact matches, so the mask is all 1s. The command to view the current SDM template being used is show SDM prefer. I use the command on my Catalyst 2960C. It's a small switch, so the numbers are much smaller than on more powerful switches. Here is the output. As I've highlighted up top, the current template is the default template. And here you can see the allocations. Note that this default template is different than the default I showed in the previous slide. That information was for the Catalyst 3750. This is a Catalyst 2960C. The templates all vary depending on switch model and sometimes software version. This default template supports 8,000 unicast MAC addresses. But the third line down, number of IPv4 unicast routes, is 0. So by default, this switch is a layer 2 switch. I use the question mark, and here you can see the other templates available on this switch. It has 4 in total. Default, dual IPv4 and IPv6, LAN-based routing, and QoS. You can view an SDM template by using show SDM prefer, and then the template's name. Here's the LAN-based routing template. Look at the allocations this time. The number of MAC addresses is half the number of the default template, but now it can support over 4,000 unicast IPv4 routes. If I wanted to perform routing on this switch, I'd use this template. So let's see how to make the switch use this SDM template. The command from global config mode is SDM prefer, and then the template's name. So, SDM prefer LAN-based routing. Then it shows this message. Changes to the running SDM preferences have been stored, but cannot take effect until the next reload. So the command doesn't take effect immediately. I then used show SDM prefer again, and now at the bottom, there is a line saying that on next reload, the template will be LAN-based routing. So I reloaded the switch. Notice that it says system configuration has been modified, save, and I said no. I chose no just to prove a point. The SDM prefer command is configured in global configuration mode, but it won't appear in the running config. And you also won't have to save the config before restarting for it to take effect. So when you change the SDM template and reload the switch, it will ask you to save the config, but you don't actually have to save it. The SDM template change will take effect anyway. You can say yes or no at the prompt when reloading, it doesn't matter. Okay, the switch reloaded, and I used show SDM prefer again. As I've highlighted, it is now using the LAN-based routing template. The number of MAC addresses allowed with this template is 4,000, as I showed before. To confirm, I used Show MAC Address Table Count, and as you can see, the total space available is actually 4,061 MAC addresses. Currently, only two are in use, for my PC and my router. So, in my case, I clearly don't need to worry about changing the SDM template. It doesn't matter. However, if I was using many more MAC addresses, I might want to change back to the default template. A command you can use to check the current utilization of the TCAM is Show Platform TCAM Utilization. Here's the output. Here, you can see the maximum masks and values for each category. And here is the current usage. What does that mean, masks and values? TCAM is populated with masks and values. One mask stored for 8 values. The mask could be, for example, a /24 subnet mask. And then there could be 8 values in there, like 192.168.1.0, 192.168.2.0, etc. So, routes to different networks in the routing table. To repeat what I said earlier, for layer 2 forwarding, the masks will be all Fs. All bits of the mask will be 1 to look for an exact match. Now, some of the max values shown here are different than what we saw before in the output of Show SDM Prefer. For example, as I've highlighted, the max number of values for unicast MAC addresses is 5,376, not 4K as we saw before. I believe that is explained by this note down here. Basically, the information here gives an abstract view of the current utilization, but not an exact count. Okay, now what happens if a switch uses all of its TCAM for a particular feature? What if it can't hold any more MAC addresses, or any new routes in its TCAM? Exhaustion of TCAM resources can lead to, for example, flooding of frames. If a switch can't learn a MAC address, it will flood traffic destined for that MAC address. It can also lead to usage of the CPU for layer 3 forwarding, ACLs, etc. It can't program new entries into the TCAM, so the CPU has to do the work, which, as you know, is much slower. And one more point here. In a switch stack, all members use the same SDM template, the template of the stack master. And if a new switch is added with a different SDM template, it will adopt the template of the master. Before wrapping up, I want to show one more thing. I reverted my switch back to the default SDM template, as you can see here. Notice that it doesn't support IPv6. Number of directly connected IPv6 addresses 0, IPv6 unicast routes 0. In fact, if I enter global config mode and type IPv6 with a question mark, I see no commands. It just says unrecognized command. So if this is an unrecognized command, you might think the switch simply doesn't support IPv6. But actually, it does. I once again activated the LAN-based routing template and reloaded the switch. After it finished reloading, I used Show SDM Prefer again, and now, as you can see, it supports IPv6. This time, from global configuration mode, if I type IPv6 and a question mark, there are lots of options for different IPv6 commands. I'm only showing a few here. So, the point is that some features, such as IPv6, may be supported by a switch, but not available until you configure an appropriate SDM template. Okay, in this video, we covered SDM templates. Their purpose is to allow you to change how the switch's TCAM is allocated for different features. A switch doesn't have unlimited TCAM, so depending on how you use the switch, you may have to adjust the SDM template. Keep in mind that these SDM templates, their names, and how they allocate TCAM varies depending on the switch. So don't bother memorizing the template names and how they allocate TCAM. But if you're using a Cisco switch, it's a good idea to check out what SDM templates it supports, and perhaps change the SDM template if needed. Okay, now let's go on to a short quiz. Here's question 1. Switch 1 is a 4-switch stack using the LAN-based routing SDM template. You want to add a new member switch to the stack. The new switch is using the default SDM template. What will happen when the new switch joins the stack? Pause the video now to think about the answer. Okay, the answer is A. The new switch will use the land-based routing SDM template. Switches in a stack will use the SDM template of the master, and that includes any new switches you add to the stack. Okay, let's go to question 2. What mask value would you expect for a TCAM layer 2 forwarding entry? Pause the video now to think about the answer. Okay, the answer is B, 12 Fs. A MAC address is 48 bits, 12 hexadecimal digits in length. So the mask also has to be that same length. And it will be all ones, meaning that it accepts only exact matches. Okay, let's go to question 3. Which command can you use to view the current SDM template and the template that will be applied at next reload? Pause the video now to think about the answer. Okay, the answer is A, show SDM prefer. In the output of this command, it shows both the current SDM template and the one that will be applied at next reload. Note that it only shows the message at the bottom if the SDM template will be different after reloading. If you don't change the SDM template, that won't display. Okay, that's all for the quiz and this video. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members. To become a member, please click the join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, Velva Jacob, George Streeter, Funny Dart, Nasir Chowdhury, Devin Suku, Gustavo BR, Gerard Baker, Marcel Lord, Pavel M, Mr. Erlison, Drago Cerneya, Zakib Shah, Mayor Salman, Mazen Anderson, Vitaus194, Gina Lindley, Mark Jackson, Bold1C1U, Michael Carroll, Gerald Guillaume, Gabriel Braga, Renan Marias, Hector Hernandez, Mara Tuba, Roji Kuriakos, Arpad Conives, 5 Feet, Owad, Daniel Brown, Tricky Mickey 123456, Scott Thompson, Jose Alvarez, Kevin Hayes, Hussein Yavuz, Samuel Tavares, Mustafa Irsoy, Dear Diso, Nasser Zahar, Alexandru Badic, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemejev, Dibya Swain, Arlen Plagaria, Adelson Pereira, Farad69, Lucien Stoichitoyu, Madmark50484, Sean Powell, and Alexandru Stratton. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So, if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching.